Hi everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial on how to implement virtualization on the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component. Virtualization is a technique used in Blazor DataGrid to enhance the rendering performance of large datasets. It achieves this optimization by rendering only the visible portion of the data on the screen. When I scroll vertically or horizontally, the data grid dynamically loads and renders new rows or columns as needed. First, I will open the existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component and bound it to a data source. The data grid has been populated with orders data. If you want to see how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component to it, check out the video linked in the above YouTube card. You can also find this example by following the link in the provided description below. Look now, the data grid renders with orders data source. Now, I need to render 1 lakh records in the Blazor data grid. Here, I will show you how I can achieve performance improvements using virtualization, focusing on 2 key aspects, row virtualization and column virtualization. First, I will show you how to use row virtualization in the Blazor data grid. It is a performance optimization technique used to render only the visible rows of a grid. To set up row virtualization, I set the enable virtualization property to true. And set the height of the content area using the height property. This determines the number of records to be displayed in the data grid based on the content area's height. To enable cell placeholder during virtualization, I set the enable virtual mask row property to true. It shows a loading placeholder in cells when new data is loaded. The same set of DOM elements is reused to improve performance. Now, let me run the demo. As you can see, performance is improved by rendering a large number of records in the data grid. Additionally, see the loading placeholder in cells when new data is loaded. With row virtualization enabled, the data grid only renders the visible rows, resulting in faster rendering time and improved overall performance. Next, I will show you how to use column virtualization in the Blazor data grid. To demonstrate column virtualization, first, I need to add more columns to the data grid. I do this by adding additional properties to the order class and updating the values for these properties in the data list. With additional columns added, now I update the grid column tag to display the newly created properties. By doing this, see how column virtualization optimizes the rendering of columns in the data grid. To enable column virtualization, I set the enable column virtualization property to true. And set the width of the content area using the width property. This determines the number of columns to be displayed in the data grid based on the content area's width. Look now, as I scroll horizontally through the data grid, only the visible columns are rendered, and additional columns are loaded as needed. You can also see the loading placeholder when new data is loaded. This greatly improves the performance and response of our data grid when dealing with large amounts of data. However, there are some limitations of virtualization. If you want to know about limitations, check out the documentation link given below. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I demonstrated the benefits of virtualization and the 2 key aspects of virtualization in Blazor data grid, row and column virtualization. For more information on the grid features, be sure to check out the documentation link provided in the video description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.